Teach. What could be easier, right? Piece of cake. Just like snap of finger. Kaboom. Done.
Like this. And this seam is no good. Look, here is knot. And if I pull fabric here, it's just open. That's no good.
To make a nice straight stitch without knot, I have to pull both threads all the time on the back. Place fabric, pull down needle, and so several steps. After that, make finger. And again, several stitches back and front. And now we have nice, and what is important, very strong stitch. If I pull here, here is not open, and no knot here. Strong, straight, nice seam. If I won't make a nice straight seam, for example, half inch from edge of fabric, what should I do? Very easy. I will use foot presser foot J and stitch number 0. This stitch needle will be on the left position. To avoid making knot on the beginning, we have to pull threads on the back all the way, and push presser foot down, and I will just follow this edge. And here is seam. If you measure this with a ruler, it will be exactly half inch all the way. To make seam quarter inch of edge, I will use seam number 1 on my machine. And same foot J. When I set seam number 1, needle will be goes on the center, like this. Now I just have to push down presser foot and follow with the presser this edge of fabric. And now I have a perfectly quarter of inch from edge of fabric to seam. For patchwork, the best is a 1/4 quilt guide foot. It's a perfectly quarter of inch seam allowance. I press it, and now it looks like this. Very nice and very straight. If I want to make a seam along this stitch, the best way, use, you know what, blind stitch, this one. Blind stitch foot have a guide, this one, and this is adjustable. I can move it when I move this bolt, it moves. I can make it bigger or smaller. And I have perfectly nice, straight and beautiful seam. If I want to make this distance smaller, I just will move this bolt and make it smaller, and again put it on the seam. Now I have here more narrow. What if I need make a seam more than half inch from edge of fabric? For example, this pattern says seam allowance 5/8 of an inch. No any problem. For that, I will use guide stitch foot. This is guide and I can move it for any size from needle. So, I will set size 5/8. Probably it will be like this. I will check. If I'll take ruler and measure from needle, will be exactly 5/8. And here is seam. If I take ruler and measure, exactly 5/8. The biggest size I can set with a guide stitch foot is 1 inch. But sometimes I need more. For example, if I want to make, let's say, panels, rod pocket with a header, and I want to make header 1.5 inch. How I can do this? Again, very, very easy. Now I will use magnet guide, like this. It holds very strong here. Even if I will move it here where is no metal plate, it keeps pretty strong. I can use it. But I need now 1.5 inch from needle. So I put place ruler here where is needle and just measure 1.5 inch. I will use regular presser foot. Now I place fabric under foot and just follow this guide. And here is header, 1.5 inch exactly.